Hello everybody, it's Licky Giraffe here with more Dark Souls action for what I believe is part 4 of my walkthrough. So, it's been a while, so let me try to remember what I was doing. We have... we first visited the blacksmith, talked to him, got this bonfire, and now we're ready to continue our quest to ring the second bell. Yes. Now I remember. Oh yeah, so I'm using the claymore. I've got this cool ass pig helmet. It's cool as all hell. Do. Okay. Try quickly remember the controls. Take that. Scurvy barnacle. What am I doing? I killed him, sure, but at what cost? Now, if I remember, we troops in here. Yes. This monster. I remember if you rush forward towards him and attack him there, I believe that there is the channeler guy above, which just fires at you from behind and just wrecks you. Oof, ow. Okay, let's play it safe for a while. Let's try to learn his moveset. I don't think it's too many. He's got that womp attack. He's got the shield bash. And he's got sweep. Very cool shield as well. Like a good great shield. Come on. Oh no. Oh. I got too greedy. That's what happened. Titanite shard and some souls, not too bad. So, I think we go up here. Get our firekeeper soul. You can actually see him over there. Sure, now that we can activate the lift that goes back up to Firelink, but we won't do that quite yet because I want to go around the front and open up another shortcut. Oh no, not stealthy enough. Oh no, what am I doing? Like I'm asking for trouble fighting on a rickety bridge. Aha, defeat him with my superior range. Okay, leave him there. And pop down here. I could have done this before I went to the bonfire last time, but I think I needed to finish up for whatever reason, and I was feeling like playing it safe. Basement key. Pull the lever. Aha! There we are. All too easy. Now I have the basement key, though I don't remember exactly what the basement key opens. Oh, okay, opens door leading to lower undead burg. Okay, cool. Alright, I know what that is then. Wonderful. Just strangle these guys one at a time. Play it safe. You never ideally want to have a 2v1 at any point in your Dark Souls adventure. Aha. Baldur's Shield. Cool. This guy. Excuse me. Oh. Oh, I thought I heard a movement. Guess it was just me. Ah, see? Trying to trick you. Again, fool you by showing you the enemy through the door and encouraging you to rush through. Ah, no, that was stupid. My Dark Souls. Oh no. Oh, it parried me. Oh no. Oh, get told. Absolutely destroyed. How unfortunate. Oh well. That was my own fault. On the plus side, it is not very far away at all, so that's okay. It's handy that I can defeat them in about 2 blows. Because anyone waiting to hit. So then if I say make a third attack to kill them, that uses up valuable time and stamina, and it could be the difference between me defeating them nice and easily and me taking 1 or 2 hits in the process. If we go for this guy and just... no, that didn't work. Oh well. So now if I got this guy... see, do I remember how to do a kick? I do. If only it was not so poorly timed. Ah, jeez. What am I doing? I have forgotten to play this game. I apologize to everyone who just saw that. That was not good. That was, in fact, the opposite of what I would consider good. Notice how the guy down there doesn't respawn. Not sure there's anything particularly interesting to say about that, but just something I noticed. And actually, I'm gonna destroy these crates over here because you never know what's behind a good set of barrels. Say the even the look of this. Oh, come on, I thought I aggroed him. Even the look of this enemy kind of hints as to what his fighting style is. So before we had the massive guy with like a massive great shield and a big thing, and he just had big like heavy swings. He just had to avoid out of the way. Well, this guy, he's got like a rapier. He's got a small shield. Sometimes he holds it in a weird way, to like riposte or parry. And so even the look of the enemies is very indicative of like how they fight. And can help give you clues as to how to he's gonna get that away, isn't he? He is. No! Oh, I was gonna say, if I die again, I'll be so mad. Spell things. Thinking, would it be better if I went up there and rested at the Farling Shrine? Yeah, it's a bit quicker. So we will. But we will roll out early in order to what are we doing here again? She did a hold up now. Wait, we don't want to go over there quite yet. What we do want is to get down there where those chests are. How do you do that again? If I jump down there, I'm probably going to die. Yeah, okay. I will have to try harder. I guess go over to the shrine, rest up. Ooh, might as well level up too since we are, what, 8 souls away. In fact, we're so close, I'm not even going to use a little soul. I'm just going to go up here and kill a single guy. Let me get the souls I need. Because I'm nothing if not efficient. Boom, okay. Let's rest, let's level up, let's increase our strength. What do we think? Gargoyles, yeah, pretty good with strength. Important to kill one of them as quickly as you can. Let's talk to this guy as well, see if he has anything to say.
Don't you ever think to forge your weapons? You'd better find a smith box soon, unless you...
Ha 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 ha. Hilarious.
How did that silly sorcerer's apprentice end up? You know, the one always prattling on about Master Logan. He left for the Undead Burg, but never came back. Serves him right. If even old Big Hat can't make it out there, what chance does he have? I hope he enjoys his new life as a hollow.
Ouch. Tough words. Okay, so, if we run back, I might try get those chests again. I'm pretty darn certain that you don't, you can just pop down. I guess I've saved 90 all my souls, so now I would feel a little better about possibly dying. Oh yeah, that's pretty fine. That we will make that jump at a later stage once we return to the Undead Asylum. Star talisman. Remember, I always used to think that a morning star was the weapon that the Witch King of Angmar and Lord of the Rings wielded, but that is incorrect. For a morning star is what I always would have considered like a mace. Oh no, gotta get out of here quick. Yes, and I believe the Witch King of Angmar actually wields a what is the name of it again? God, I can't even remember. I should never have brought it up. Now I look like a fool. Oh well. Okay, let's get our health back. Have a nice rest. Okay, now. Back into that undead church place. here we are. So I might try equip a shield that has better magic resistance. That's 55. Oh, 55 is the best I can get. I might put on the wooden shield then. Just in case I need to block some of his some of this guy's magical like bolts. Oh no, forgot we had to kill these guys. Come at me, bro. See, now he's got his, it's like his cool grip on, ready to riposte you if you're not careful. Then he loses it. Oh, and there's the backstab. Haha. Take that, you monster. Ooh, some Baldur gauntlets. Cool. I think there is one more of him. No, there's not. Wonderful. Oh, no. Too slow. So now, very interesting. Very interesting time where suddenly the weakest enemy in the game is suddenly surprisingly powerful when faced with a horde of them. It is surprisingly tough because you don't normally have to do this. Normally you fight one enemy or two enemies at a time and that's it, but faced with five or six enemies and it suddenly becomes an entirely different prospect and sometimes very difficult. Going. Aha! Cannot hide from me, evildoer. Okay, cool. That's that done. So now, before we head up to the bell tower. Oh, excuse me. Need to defeat this guy. Now, luckily, I'm pretty sure in a way that the channeler guy does not reappear. Oh, backstab, yeah. Which is wonderful, because he's a pain in the ass. Okay, he's dead now. We continue on. Run. Actually, for now, before I forget, for the gargoyles, I will now equip a shield with a lot of fire resistance. I think 70 is the most. Yeah, 70. Oh, cool, and it's the heater shield. I just love that 100% physical damage reduction. I'm a sucker for it. Okay, let's go through here. Let's release this dude. Get some humanity. Mystery key open.
Thank you. I am Knight Lautrec of Cali. I truly appreciate this. And I guarantee a reward. Only later.
Pretty reasonable.
Yes, very so. I've just been.
Alrighty. hindsight, I probably should have turned myself human before I left the bonfire. Since I'd be able to summon what's his name? Sunbro to help me with this. But oh well, if I die, then I can summon the Sunbro. There's always that satisfaction of defeating them by yourself. So nothing over there. Do do do. Okay. Max my health. All right, let's do this. I love. So you step through the fog gate. You're like, okay, cool. Then you know, like, probably boss incoming, and then suddenly step out, and you can't see any enemies. Instead, you have a nice, pleasant view, and you see a bell tower. Ah, no, but wait. Shit, son. Gargoyle Town. Gargoyle Tail Axe. Now, fairly interestingly enough, he is unable to use his tail weapon to attack me. Okay, I did some good damage there. Now we have the second guy to contend with. So here, they do a very, very interesting idea. Are they, can I get through here? I can. Where, so suddenly, you know, like, alright, take a guy one by one. Now suddenly, here's two bosses for you to attack. It's an amazing idea. And you just have to be so careful. One mistake and you are a goner. Now I apologize, because this could take me a while. Thankfully I have my heater shield, so I can block a lot of this, but between the fire and the constant attacking, it's a real mess. For me. Yeah, there we go. Darn, darn, darn. I did so well, too. Oh, well. Yeah, if I'd only killed that guy. See, because individually, they're not that hard, but what's it going to say? It's both together. That's the most difficult. Let me think. I want to turn myself human, but to do that, I need to rest at the bonfire. I'll give it a few more goes, I think. Do 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 do. Because I've done this before by myself, so it's definitely possible. think, yeah, I think I probably should have been more patient. I had a lot of Estus flasks left. So much so that I probably could have continued to jab away at the weak guy when possible. It's like, once you kill one of them, it's pretty easy. Yeah, like I said, all of the difficulty is in having to fight two of them. And it's very interesting because it kind of just changes the dynamic of the fight totally. Instead of being able to do, say, what you've normally done for the last few guys, which is, like, circle around them and, like, try and backstab them or whatever, now suddenly you have to contend with what happens when, like, oh, so this guy is pretty weak and he's got some really obvious moves and they're easy to block, he doesn't do that much damage, but there's another guy here where if I try and attack, he will just wreck me up with his fire. Will I try to run through? I think I will. Oh no, oh no, what a dreadful idea. What have I done? Haha, it worked. Question is now, can they climb ladders? So they can. Amazing. If I fall down, I'm probably dead. So I gotta be careful. Last one. Yes. Now, actually, I probably could have just ignored them and kept going, because once you step through the fog gate, it closes behind you. But, hey-ho, what you gonna do? Now, where did I die? Pick up my power. Second guy's down. I did a lot less damage this time, which is a bit of a shame. Ow. Such a long reach as well. Look at that. He is just defended with flame. Get some health, anyway. And yeah, just try and avoid getting stuck. Ah, jeez, what am I doing? I need to focus. Attack him because he's wreathed in fire. Hit some health down while I can. Ow. Oh, one is almost down. Hold on, because I'm a little low for my liking. important thing as well is to keep them both on the same side. Because if they get on opposite sides of you, then you are very dead very quickly. Ah, no, I missed. I really need to connect, as I am beginning to run low on Estus lasts. Fire, fire everywhere. No. No. Okay. Two, oh, there's three, not okay, three left, three left. Identity do. Everything is fine. It's just relentless attack. Estus flask. Fire, fire everywhere. Oh no, so close. Okay, one Estus flask left. No. Probably not going to do this. Oh my god. Okay. Okay. This serious now, yo. Gotta play real smooth. No chances. Yes! Oh my god, yes! Ha 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 ha! Ah! Victory achieved! Fuck yes! Yes! Ha ha! Wonderful. That was so hard. Like, I've done them before, and I would consider them to be one of the hardest bosses. I just, they're so darn difficult. You need to be so careful with when you attack. Amazing. Although I don't think it's ever been that close. Man, the relief has flooded over me. I'm glad you guys were there to see my triumph. That was wonderful. Okay, so now here we are. The first bell. Brilliant. And now If you remember, I hate the way it puts that there. Calm down, there we go. So now we've run the first bell of awakening, and if you remember when he was telling us about the bell of awakening, one is up on the tower and the other is down in Blighttown. Why can't I? There we go. So now, and because we got the basement key there earlier when we opened that gate shortcut, we now have access to the depths, or Blighttown, or whatever the hell that area is called. Oh look, a person.
Greetings. I am Oswald of Kareem, the Pond.
Ooh, same place as the other guy we saved.
Yet magnanimous are the gods. Cometh out of them first, for to accuse. For indeed all sins I do.
Gesture, well, what is it? Amazing. Actually, what can I buy of him again? Indictment. Book of the guilty. Okay. Nothing too mad. Useful though, because he does sell the item if you get cursed. But we, of course, aren't planning to get cursed at all during this run through. Ah, oh, sweet mercy. It reminds me of very first time I beat Ornstein and Schmau in my first run through, where I think it was maybe third time, so like I died twice. I went in and I killed Schmau first, so then it was just me and Ornstein, and I remember I chewed through all of my Estus flasks, and he was I think at half health in his like super powerful mode, and I remember I somehow managed to whittle him down and defeat him from half health with no Estus flasks remaining, and that was an amazing fight. Now unfortunately I didn't record it any or anything, but it was fabulous. I felt really great, and of course that was the first time I'd ever beaten Ornstein and Smough. Now of course I had bragging rights and joined my esteemed fellows who had also defeated the dangerous duo. But finally, at the end of that, we find ourselves back at the Undead Berg and Firelink Shrine, to be specific. Let's have a good rest. Incredible. Right, let's see. I want to get more endurance. Actually, because then I can wield the Zyhander, and I want to see which one I prefer. So we need, 36,000 for my next level. Soul of a Lost Undead. Next we need large Soul of a Lost Undead. How much do those give us again? Only 400. There we go, that's what I'm talking about. Bring up to 20. Cool. And then, actually, something else. I want to reverse Holloway for humanity, yes. Hooray! Okay, so now I believe we can wield the Zyhander. Yes. I forgot I got that gargoyle tail axe too. Cool. Zyhander. Amazing. So yeah, I'll probably use this for a while and see how I like it, because it's got a little bit longer range than the claymore, which I enjoy. But I've never actually used it properly, and I want to give both of them a good run through. Let there be light. So now, as well, I totally forgot we got a firekeeper soul I see. That would have been useful for the the gargoyles. That's reinforced. Boom. Okay, we're looking in a pretty darn good shape. I have yet to lose like a decent amount of souls. We're, what soul level are we? 24. Got my Zyhander. And so now I believe I'm probably going to call it there for part 4. But where are we going next? We're heading into the lower Undeadburg for with some eventual Blight Town action, I believe. So, yes, with that, thank you very much for watching, and I will see you for part 5.